愿大家平安。
Peace be with all everyone.
下午我们来讲愿神作王这个题目。
This afternoon, I'd like to share the topic, Let God Reign.
上午从昨天我们就一直探讨信仰的一个过程。
From yesterday morning, we studied the process of faith.
信仰是从我们受洗那一天开始。
Faith begins the day we are baptized.
到我们最后一口气要离开世界那一刹那。
Until the last moment of our breath in this world.
神已经命定，每个人的时间不一样。
God has set a different time for each of us.
有长有短。
They're long and they're short.
但是神会让我们遇到很多的事情。
God will allow us to encounter many things.
目的是要让我们的信仰可以从一个阶段进入另外一个阶段。
The purpose is for our faith to enter from one stage into progressing into another.
从罗马书的第五章，我们学习到，我们信仰首先是要与神和好。
Romans 5, we learned that we must reconcile our faith. We must reconcile with God first.
然后再靠着主耶稣的生能够得救。
And then by Lord Jesus, we can be saved.
这样我们能荣耀神。
And then we can glorify God.
然后我们最后就以神为乐。
And then we will have delight in God.
信仰应该是很开心的。
So faith should be a very joyous matter.
来灵恩会应该是很开心的。
Coming to spiritual convocation should be a joyous matter.
是不是，弟兄姐妹？
Is it not so, brothers and sisters?
刚刚吃的那么饱是很开心的。
Are you very glad that you had such a sumptuous lunch?
虽然现在很想睡觉，也是很开心的。
Although you're a little sleepy now, but you're still very joyous.
就算睡，也在神的教堂里面睡。
Even if you fall asleep, you're sleeping in the house of God.
至少你不在家里睡。
At least you're not falling asleep on your own couch at home.
这很开心，看到弟兄姐妹应该是很开心的。
So seeing brothers and sisters here worshiping together, this is a very joyous occasion. Prayer is a joyous occasion.
如果你来聚会觉得很不开心。
If you come to church and you don't feel very joyful.
看到弟兄姐妹也很不开心。
And when you see other brothers and sisters, you feel joyful.
听道理又觉得很无聊。
You listen to sermons and you feel bored.
那不是神出的问题。
It's not the problem does not lie in God.
是你自己的问题。
But rather it lies in ourselves.
你收不到神的讯号啊。
We're unable to receive the signal that God transmits.
你这个机器啊有问题啊。
There's something wrong with our own device.
不是没电了就是坏掉了。
Either it's out of battery or it's defective.
神一直都在哪里。
God is always there.
神拣选你就是要你快乐，要你在神里面喜乐。
He chose us so that we can have joy in the Lord.
如果你喜乐不出来，要找到问题的原因在哪里。
If you can't find joy in there, then we have to discover where the problem lies.
在罗马书的第五章里面呢，还有讲到一点。
Romans chapter 5 also mentions another point.
我们要追求的。
We have to pursue this.
在信仰上，我们要让神作王。
In our faith, we must let God reign.
我们看罗马书的五章十七节。
Let's read Romans 5, verse 17.
罗马书五章十七节。
Romans 5, verse 17.
若因一人的过犯，死就因这一人做了王，何况那些受洪恩又蒙所赐之义的，岂不更要因耶稣基督一人在生命中作王吗？
For if by one man's offense death reigned through the one, much more those who receive abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness will reign in life through the one, Jesus Christ.
信仰就是要一场征战，一场 struggle, 一场那个斗争。
Faith itself is a struggle and a battle.
怎么斗争呢？
How is it a struggle?
我们看电影啊，看电视，看小说，它之所以好看，就是因为里面有 struggle, 有 conflict。有一个争斗在里面。
Movies, TV shows, and dramas or novels are very interesting because it involves conflict.
一定有两方面。
And there's always two sides.
到最后呢，一定是一方面克服了另外一方面。
And in the end, one side will overcome the other.
那我们信仰上也是一样。
This is the same in our own faith.
没有信耶稣之前。
Before we believed in Christ.
或者是我们信仰还没有被蒙光照之前。
Before the light has shone upon us in our faith.
我们是让罪做我们的生命的王。
Then sin reigned as our king.
因为罪从一个人进到世界。
For sin entered the world through one man.
全世界都犯了罪。
And the entire world does sin.
所以全世界都听罪的话。
And so the entire world falls under the command of sin.
这个世界有一个最大的权柄。
There is the greatest authority in this world.
就是罪。
That is sin.
只要你是属于他的人，你就一定会听他的话。
If you belong to sin, then you will listen to it.
无论你在哪一个文化，哪一种教育水平。
No matter what culture or what background education you have.
你是穷的还是富的。
Whether you're poor or rich.
你没有信耶稣，你就在罪的权柄之下。
If you don't believe in Jesus, then you're under the dominion of sin.
你每天跟着他走。
Follow it every day.
你所想的。
Everything that you think
of. 所做出来的。
Everything that you do.
都是被控制。
Is controlled.
但是如果我们信了主耶稣之后，
But after we believe in Jesus,
这里说我们就是要让主耶稣基督在我们生命当中作王。
Says here that we will let Jesus reign in our life.
就是要把信仰，就是要把旧的那个王给赶走。
The faith is to cast out or overthrow the old king,
the godliness. And
to invite the true king, Lord Jesus Christ, as our into our throne.
如果是在社会上, 政治上来说, 这个叫革命, 这句话, From 这个字很敏感,
societal standpoint, this is called a revolution.
因为革命是要流血的,
revolution involves bloodshed.
但是有时候革命是需要的,
and sometimes it's necessary.
你不流血, 你就改变不了, 你不革命,
if there's no bloodshed, then no change can come about. No revolution can come about.
每一个文化, 每一个国家, 都有一些经历过革命,
every country, every culture has gone through some sort of revolution.
像法国有法国大革命,
French had the French Revolution.
革命完了, 哇, 新的自由平等,
after
民主就起来了,
the revolution, there is a new society with more equality.
有一些国家的革命, 革命完了, 就往另外一个方向发展,
but other countries after revolution, they develop in another way, in another direction.
属灵上, 我们信耶稣信仰也是要来一场革命。
In our faith with Lord Jesus Christ, we also must have this revolution.
是在里面的革命,
this is an internal revolution.
你信耶稣就是要把里面的旧的王魔鬼罪
Or believing in Lord Jesus, it requires us to cast out, overthrow the king in our hearts, that is Satan.
然后请生命的君王耶稣基督进来替你做主，替你统治。
And to invite the King of Life, Lord Jesus, to reign in us.
你可以想象这个过程有多艰难。
You can imagine how arduous this process is.
这个过程不是给慕道者听的, 这个是我们信了主之后还一直在进行。
This process is not only for a new believers, but rather for believers that have been believed for a long time.
我们信了主了, 就要追求, 要让主耶稣, 让神来作王。
After we believe in Christ, we have to pursue to allow God to reign in us.
除非你做到这一点, 不然的话没有生命跟平安。
If we don't achieve this point, we will not have life and peace.
那么怎么样可以做得到?
So how can we achieve this?
我们今天来分享几点。
So today we'll share a couple of points.
第一点呢,
the first,
我们一定要让神的恩典 彻彻底底地在我们生命当中作王。
We have to allow the grace of God to reign inside us completely.
让神作王就是让恩典在我们心中作王的意思。
To allow God to reign in us also means to have His grace reign inside of us.
我们看罗马书第六章。
Let's read Romans 6.
罗马书第六章。
Romans 6.
十二节。
Verse 12.
罗马书六章十二节。
Romans 6 verse 12.
所以不要容罪在你们必死的身上作王，使你们顺从身子的私欲。
Therefore, do not let sin reign in your mortal body, that you should obey it in its lusts.
也不要将你们的肢体献给罪，做不义的器具，倒要像从死里复活的人，将自己献给神，并做肢体做义的器具献给神。
And do not present your members as instruments of unrighteousness to sin, but present yourselves to God as being alive from the dead, and your members as instruments of righteousness to God.
这里告诉我们一点。
Here tells us a point.
我们信主之后要一直追求，要把旧的王，就是罪，赶走。
After we believe in Jesus, we must continually pursue overthrowing that old king, which is sin.
把自己的献给义，献给对的事情，献给神来做王。
Dedicate ourselves to righteousness to allow God to reign in us.
那这个很难，因为人都有罪性。
This is not easy because we all have sinful nature.
我们比较喜欢那些不好的事情。
We tend to enjoy those things that are not good.
这有点像啊，那个那些好吃的食物啊。 都对身体不太好的，很多都是这样。
Think about it. Most of the food that's really delicious are not good for your health.
是不是？
Isn't it so?
煎的啦，炸的啦，油的啦，辣的啦。
The fry.
肉啊，吃太多啊。
The meat.
好像好吃的都对身体不好。
It seems like everything that we find tasty is not good for our health.
啊，那个不好吃的对身体很好。
But those things that are pretty, that we find gross are actually good for our bodies.
要逼自己吃，哇，很痛苦。这个怎么那么苦？这个怎么那么没有味道？
To try to feed ourselves those kind of food.
哇，你看，要犯罪很舒服啊，很简单啊。
In the same way, committing sins is very enjoyable. It's very easy.
你要跟随神很困难。But
to follow God is very difficult.
你要走世界的路，哇，很自然，很舒服，放松就可以了，什么都不用做。
It's very natural and easy to walk the way of this world.
顺服你肉体的需要。
To follow the lusts of your flesh.
你眼想看什么就看。
What you want to see, yeah, you see.
嘴巴想讲什么就讲。
What you want to speak, you speak.
心里面想什么你就想。
And whatever your heart thinks, so you allow it to continue thinking.
这个就是罪性。
This is a sinful nature.
我们今天活在全人类历史最罪恶的一个时代。
Today we live in the most sinful time in human history.
这个罪透过高科技无孔不入地进入我们每一个人的生活当中。
Sin through ubiquitous technology has penetrated to all of our lives.
现在很多人被手机控制了。
Many people today are controlled by their cell phones.
醒过来就是手，我的手机在哪里？他眼睛都还没有找啊，都在找手机。
The first thing they wake up before their eyes are even open is to look for their cell phone.
起来都还没有去小便，都是找手机。
Before even using the restroom in the morning, they look for their cell phone.
睡觉躲在棉被里面也在看手机。
Even when they're under the cover, they're looking for their cell phone.
到底在看什么？
What are they actually looking at?
但每个人看的东西不一样。
Of course, everyone looks at different things.
但是完全被手机控制。
But they're completely controlled by their cell phone.
比那个鸦片还严重，还厉害。
It's even worse than drugs.
那魔鬼透过科技用罪来控制了人。
The devil, through technology, controls us by sin.
以前要看不好的东西, 你还要偷偷摸摸的去超市, 假装没事的买一本那个不好的杂志。
In the past, if you
买的时候还不能只买那个, 还要顺便买一点别的东西来。
In the past, if you wanted to look at a dirty magazine, perhaps you would go to a grocery store and buy other items along with a dirty magazine.
还要偷偷摸摸的带回家看那么大本, 怕被人家发现, 看完之后还要藏起来。
And you have to secretly take it home and look at it in private and then hide it.
对不对? 怕被父母看到。
And isn't that so? It's afraid your parents may find out.
怕被太太看到就麻烦了。
Afraid your spouse might find out.
现在呢? 哇, 一台手机什么都有得看。
But today, with the cell phone, you can see anything that your heart desires.
还是高速的网络。
And it's even high speed.
记得我第一次接触网络的时候，还在读大学。
I remember the first time I interacted with the internet was when I was in college.
那时候网络慢的比乌龟还慢。
At the time, it was slower than a turtle.
只能够打一个 email 就等了半天。
Even composing an email, sending an email took forever.
还要打那个嘟嘟嘟嘟嘟嘟。
And then we had to go with dial-up connections.
Download 一个 picture, 一个图片, 要5分钟。
And downloading a picture through dial-up took about 5 minutes.
Download那么久，还算了，不看。
And to download so long that I just forgot about it.
我没有什么试探。
And there's not really any temptation.
因为网络太慢了，所以没有试探，很少试探。
The speed of the internet was too slow back then to be a temptation.
现在太快了。
But today it is too fast.
你都来不及想不想看，它就 pop up 给你看。
Even before
要不要进来？要不要进来？
Even before deciding whether or not you want to look at it, it's already there in your face.
有赌博的网站，它叫你进来 ，click here.
Gambling sites invite you to click here.
哦，要色情的网站 ，click here.
Pornographic sites invite you to click there.
打那个不好的电动了 ，click here.
Or those violent games invite you to click somewhere else.
但是我就没有看到一个 Bible 的网站，圣经的网站说 click here, God is here. 没有看到这种。
I've never seen a Bible site that says click over here.
所以我们神国圣经的。 神的话，我们这个科技战里面彻底的失败，彻底的跟不上这个，达不上那个罪恶。
So God's word, the kingdom of God itself, is a failure in terms of in this technological age.
大家拼命分享一些无聊的、没有营养的、不造就的。
Everyone shares about all the frivolous things and the boring things of life.
不然的话，你看弟兄姐妹的那些社交网站，看一下他们在分享什么。
If you look at the social media of our own members. What are they looking at?
很少人分享神的话。
Very few people share the words of God.
所以科技彻底的让我们控制。
Technology has totally controlled us.
如果你要改变，你要先改变你用科技的用习惯。
If we want to truly change and have a revolution, we have to change the way we use technology.
人有罪性。
Humans have sinful nature.
要控制很难。
It's very difficult for us to control it.
所以你要对你的配偶老实。
So we have to be truthful with our spouse.
我控制不了，你要帮我。
If I can't control myself, you have to help me.
好，互相呢。 来祷告，帮助祷告。
Have to mutually pray for each other.
现在很多婚姻的问题都是很多婚姻里面配偶之间的问题，其实是其中一方沉迷了网络。
Today, many problems within a marriage arise from being too deep in the internet.
很多孩子的问题都是因为他沉迷网络。
And many problems with the kids and their parents are also because the kids are addicted to the internet.
很多父母啊，他以为说啊，我孩子啊。 读小学了，需要台电脑啊，做功课比较好。Some
parents think that their kids need a computer in order to, even in elementary school.
很早就给他 iPad， 很早就给他电脑。
To do their homework, and so they give them an iPad or a laptop very early on.
结果你害死他。
And then they end up harming them.
自从你给他的那一天，你就收不回来了。From
the day that you give it to them, that's the last day you can get it back.
他看什么，你控制不到。
And whatever they watch, you can't control them.
你以为你可以控制他，他比你更聪明。
If you think you can control them, they can actually outsmart you.
你弄一道墙，他帮你跳墙。If
you set up a wall, they'll jump over it.
所以现在很多年轻人就是被罪透过科技被绑住了。
So nowadays, many of the youth are bound by sin through technology.
如果你已经被绑住，If
you've already been in chains,
你灵恩会祷告要悔改。Then
pray for and repent during the spiritual convocation.
求圣灵洁净你。
Pray for the Holy Spirit to cleanse you.
戒掉这个毒瘾，戒掉这个罪的这个习惯。
To give up this addiction.
如果你孩子还没有电脑，还没有 iPad， 不要那么早给他。
And if your kids do not have an iPad or a computer yet, don't give it to them so early.
尤其是中学之前，根本不需要自己的这种电子东西。
Especially before middle school, they have really no need for these kind of devices.
为什么他需要自己有一台 iPad?
Why do they need their own iPad?
为什么他需要自己有一台 laptop?
Why do they need their own laptop?
他要用，问你借就好了。
If they want to use it, they can borrow from you.
他去看了什么，你知道。
And that way you can monitor what they're watching.
只等到他真的是上了高中了，有需要。
Once they enter into high school, they may have need of it for school or a college.
你太早给他，你就让魔鬼多一个控制，然后去控制他。
But if you give them these devices too early on in their life, you give the devil another opportunity to control them.
不义的器具啊，现在科技啊，这是不义的，很多，不当然不是说科技是不好，但是魔鬼用的很厉害。
It's not saying that technology is bad, but there's also the devil uses them in an unrighteous way.
So we must let God reign.
So we have to let God reign in our lives.
灵恩会当中要彻底的自己思考，到底有没有生活当中的罪还在控制了我们。
In the spiritual convocation, we must reflect to see what kind of sins are controlling us today.
其实我们都是罪人。
We are all sinners.
我们没有一个比别人好。No
one is better than the other.
但是让神作王啊，就是因为我们曾经在罪当中想起神的恩典有多大。
We allow God to reign in us because we remember how great the grace of God was in our sin.
所以就像罗马书所说的，神的恩典在生命当中作王了。Just
like in Romans 5, it says that God Himself reigns in our life.
透过他的恩典
through His grace.
保罗怎么看神的恩典呢？
How did Paul view God's grace?
我们看提摩太前书。
Let's turn to 1 Timothy.
提摩太前书第一章。
1 Timothy 1.
第十五节。
1 Timothy 1 verse 15.
提摩太前书一章的十五节。
1 Timothy 1 verse 15.
一章的十五节。
1 Timothy 1 verse 15.
基督耶稣降世，为要拯救罪人，这话是可信的，是十分可佩服的。This
is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptance that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief.
如果我们只读到这里的话，If
we read until this point,
我们可能觉得说，哇，有一个布道家说，基督耶稣来救罪人，你们都是罪人，请你们悔改。
If we read to this point, we may think that there was an evangelist that says Jesus Christ came to save sinners, and so you must repent. But Paul is not this kind of evangelist.
保罗啊，为什么他的布道这么有力量？
Why was his evangelism so effective?
他不是说你们是罪人。
He did not say you are sinners.
保罗怎么说？
But what did he say?
在罪人中，我是个罪魁。
He said, among sinners, I am chief.
为什么保罗有那么大的力量？
Why was Paul so full of strength?
为什么保罗他的一生的侍奉能够带领那么多人来信主？
Why was his life of servitude able to draw so many people to believe in Jesus?
为什么保罗在侍奉当中没有放弃？
Paul, in his servitude, he never gave up.
因为他一直记得神的恩典。He
kept, he remembered the God's grace.
我们来看看呢，中文是看不出来。你看英文或是原文，这个时态啊，是我是 I am， 我还是个罪魁。
If you read in the English or Hebrew version, it says very clearly here that I am in the present tense.
他应该用说，我曾经是个罪魁，我现在不是，我是个圣人，所以你们要悔改。
He did not say I was the chief of sinners, and you're sinners now, so you must repent.
他说我是，就现在是的，我是个罪魁。But
he says in the present tense, I am, meaning I am still a sinner.
怎么理解呢？
How can you understand? How can we understand this?
当然，从灵的角度来说，他信主那一天，他的罪就被主耶稣洗干净了。
From a spiritual angle, the day that he was baptized, his sins were cleansed by God.
但是他没有忘记。But
he did not forget.
他是一个罪人。That
he was still a sinner.
他只是一个蒙恩的罪人。He
is only a sinner,
被洁净过的罪人。By
grace, and that was cleansed.
我还是很不好。But
he is still not.
这种想法很重要。我还是很不好。This
is an important concept to know that we are still not perfect. We're still not good enough.
有信仰的我们有一个最危险的事情。In
our faith, there is a very dangerous situation.
当我们追求信仰的过程当中，越来越虔诚。This
process of our faith, as we become more and more devout.
但是如果我们不小心，会越来越自义。
But if we're not careful, we gradually become more self-righteous.
自义是很危险的。
Self-righteousness is extremely dangerous.
我得救了。Because
we feel that we can be saved.
你还没有。And
you haven't.
我的生活水准，我是圣洁的。My standard, 我是按照神的旨意行的。My
standard of living is holy, living in the standard of God.
你们很脏。And
you are all dirty and
filthy. 这就是一种心中的自义。And
this is a kind of self-righteousness that we may have in our hearts.
所以保罗每次提醒我是个罪人，这个观念在他心中。
So Paul always reminded people that he is a sinner.
所以每次因为想到这样，就想起神的恩典。
So every time he thought about this, he thought about the grace of God.
神最大的恩典不是帮我找到一份工作。
God's grace to him is not for me is not to find a job for me.
不是给我买一个栋房子。
It's not for me to be able to afford a house.
神最大的恩典是救我这个罪人。
But the greatest grace that God has given me is to save a sinner like myself.
我这个垃圾。
I am rubbish.
我这个没人要的。
I am unwanted.
上个礼拜我去一个弟兄家里访问。
Last week I went to a brother's house for visitation.
他本来有两只猫。
He originally had two cats.
有一只不见了。
One was lost. 我
去的时候有一只不见了。
When I was there, one was missing.
我问他说，那哪一只？那一只呢？那一只猫为什么不见？
And I asked him, where is that one cat that you had?
他说我给丢了。
He says I lost it.
不是给丢了，我是捐给那个 shelter 了。
He says I gave it to a shelter.
为什么？
I said, why?
他那只猫不听话。
He said, that cat was disobedient.
在家里乱撒尿。
He peed all over the house.
要大便。
And pooed all over the house.
到处抓我的墙壁。
And clawed all through the walls.
把我的电线都咬破了。
And then chewed up all the wires.
忍无可忍了。
I could stand it no longer.
我把它捐给那个运动动物的保护单位。
So I gave the cat to an animal shelter.
意思是说没有他不要他了。
Meaning that he didn't want the cat anymore.
那如果六个月在那边没有人收养的话，有人就会给他打针，就人道给他毁灭了。
And if in 6 months no one would adopt the cat, then it would be euthanized.
你去外面宠物店，如果你想买一只猫，买一只小狗。
If you go to the pet store, you want to buy a puppy or a cat.
你会怎么挑？
How would you choose them?
这个好可爱哦。
You choose the cute one.
哎呀，这个好白哦。
Or the more pure white ones.
这个那么可爱，好抱回家。
Oh, this one's so cute. I will take it home with me.
你不会挑那个，哎呀，这个掉毛的。
You won't take the one that's shedding all sorts of hair.
这个长皮肤病的。
Or has some kind of skin disease.
这个瘦的。
Or overly skinny one.
你肯定不会买它回来。
You will not find a very gaunt one.
这个送给你，你都不要。
Even if they gave it to you, you wouldn't take it.
哇，但是我们的神啊，就去把我们这些罪人捡回来。
Yet our God took each of these ourselves and took a sin.
想到每一次都想到神的这个恩典。
Every time we think of the grace of God.
你还会去犯罪吗？
Would we still continue sinning?
你舍得让主耶稣再伤心一次吗？
Would we want to break Lord Jesus' heart once again?
你还舍得离开主不来教会吗？
Would we want to depart from the Lord and not come to church anymore?
你想到神的恩典，神的恩典在我们生命当中就作王了。
When we think about the grace of God, it is going to reign in our lives.
每天都是靠神的恩典活着。
We live day by day by the grace of God.
每天都享受神的恩典。
Every day we enjoy His grace.
每天都纪念神的恩典。
Every day we remember His grace.
我上个礼拜从多伦多去那个蒙特蒙特罗去巡牧。
Last month I was sent from Toronto to Montreal to visit.
中间要开车差不多650公里。
Drove about 650 kilometers there.
我都跟别人说我开车技术很差。
I tell people that I'm a bad driver.
我都夸自己的软弱，夸完之后就有人帮我开车。
I boast of my own weaknesses, and then another person would drive for me.
我在多伦多都不用去远途的都不用自己开车。
When I go long distance in Toronto, I don't have to drive myself.
那每次都有不同的人开车帮我开车。
There's always different people driving for me.
那这次的这是一个弟兄帮我开车。
So this time a brother drove me.
那个弟兄说我等了很久了。
The brother said I waited a long time for this.
传道，我想带你去访问。
He said I want to take you for visitation.
那为什么那么好？
I said, why so good?
我买了一台新车。
He said, I bought a brand new car.
哇，这台新车啊，性能很好的。
And this new car is so brand new, it feels so good.
那个四轮全动的。
It's a four-wheel drive car.
那比较大台的，坐起来比较舒服的。
It's a larger car, it's comfortable.
我要用这台车来带你去访问。
I want to take this car and take you around for visitation.
因为他说，因为我信了主一年了，我也没有办法参与什么圣工。
Says I believe in the Lord for about a year now, and I'm unable to participate in any holy work.
你叫我讲道，我也不会。
I don't know how to give sermons.
翻译我也不懂英文，也不会。
I don't know English in order to interpret.
我也不会煮饭。
I don't know how to cook.
我就是会开车。
I only know how to drive.
那不然我帮你开车。
So how about I drive for you?
哎呦，我开车的时候，你可以在旁边跟我一对一的给我造就。
And then as I'm driving, you can edify me. We can have a one-on-one conversation.
我现在想那么累啊，六个钟头还要讲道啊。
And I thought that's so tiring for me to give sermon for 6 hours.
这样子好是好了，感谢主啊！你帮我开车就聊天聊天。
But thank the Lord, He was able to drive for me, and we were able to have conversations.
这个都是他给我造就，都是他在给我上课。
And so throughout the ride, he was actually the one edifying me.
他以前呢？真的是过罪人的生活。
He said he was living a life truly of that of a sinner.
在自己的国家当官了。
In his own country, he was a government official.
当法官了。
He was a judge.
但是呢，因为没有认识神。
But because he did not know God.
在这种不好的体制里面。
in that kind of a corrupt environment.
他没有办法用政治来审判人，这是按照上面的意思来审判人。
He was unable to judge people justly, but rather he
有时候逼着要去往政治。
But rather it was by the influence of his superiors.
别人收钱，别人贪污，我也要贪污啊，不然的话怎么可以生存？
If other people took bribes, he would have to take bribes too in order to survive.
有了钱，又去做了一些不好的事，不好的习惯。
Once he took in money, he also participated in other things that are developed very bad habits.
基本上我真的是以前很不好。
And he was basically saying that he lived a very, very sinful life.
但是我这种人，今天主耶稣竟然救我。
But yet today, Lord Jesus saved a man like me.
不单只拣选我信基督教，还从其他的教会认识真教会。
Not only brought me into Christianity, but also from there allowed me to know the true church.
要领受了圣灵。
And to receive the Holy Spirit.
所以我现在开始一定要报答神的恩典。
So he says, from now on, I will repay the grace of God.
你以后去蒙特利尔，不要叫别人去了，我每次帮你开。
Anytime you want to go to Montreal, don't ask anybody else. I'll drive for you.
这是我可以做到的事情。
This is something that at least the minimum I could do.
他还跟我讲，神给他买到这辆车。
Say, God bless me with this car.
他没有什么钱。
He does not have much money.
但是他知道需要换一台比较大一点、比较安全一点的车。
But he knew he had to get another car, a bigger, a safer car.
有一天在家里附近那个 dealer 就看到这一台。
So one day, by in his neighborhood dealer, he saw this car.
才15,000块。
It was only about $15,000.
是一台美国车。
It's an American car.
他看得很宝贵，说神赐给我一台美国车。
And he thought so precious that God has blessed him with an American car.
神赐给我一台四轮全动的车。
He blessed me with a four-wheel drive.
传道，以后这台车，我来载你。
He said, Pastor, from now on, I will drive you in this car.
我看他讲这段话的时候，眼睛都发亮了，这样子。
And when I saw him speaking these words, my eyes got bigger.
我心里想说，感谢神。
In my heart, I thought, thank the Lord.
神的恩典在他的心中作王。
The grace of God is reigning in his heart.
今天我们很多人为什么不喜乐？很多人为什么不喜乐？
How come many people today are not joyful?
为什么我们的信仰很软弱？
Why is our faith so weak?
我们已经得了神很多的恩典。
We have already received much grace from God.
但是常常不觉得神给了我们很多恩典。
But oftentimes we don't feel that it's enough.
还要求更多不同的恩典。
We desire and ask for more grace and blessings.
常常觉得别人欠我们很多。
We often feel that other people owe us a lot.
老板欠我了。
My boss owes me.
太太欠我了。
My wife owes me.
先生欠我了。
My husband owes me.
父母欠我的。
My parents owe me.
全世界都在欠你。
The entire world is indebted to me.
神也欠我了。
God also owes me.
这样的怎么会喜乐？
How can one be joyful with this attitude?
忘记了记录耶稣的恩典。
Because we've already forgotten about the grace of Lord Jesus Christ.
所以我们从现在开始。
So from this day forward.
要以基督的恩典来我们在我们身上作王。
Let the grace of Lord Jesus Christ reign in us.
保罗没有忘记他从神领受了什么。
Paul did not forget what he received from God.
我们看哥林多后书的第五章。
Let's read 2 Corinthians chapter 5.
13节。
2 Corinthians 5 verse 13.
哥林多后书五章十三节。
2 Corinthians 5 verse 13.
五章十三节。
5 verse 13.
我们若果癫狂是为神，若果谨守是为你们。
For if we are beside ourselves, it is for God, or if we are of sound mind, it is for you.
原来基督的爱激励我们，因我们想一人既替众人死，众人就都死了。
For the love of God, Christ compels us, because we judge thus, that if one died for all, then all died.
并且他替众人死，是叫那些活着的人，不再为自己活，乃为替他们死而复活的主活。
And he died for all, that those who live shall live no longer for themselves, but for him who died for them and rose again.
保罗的心里面一直有一团火。
Paul's heart continually burned with fire.
这个叫基督的爱。
This is called the love of Christ.
一直催逼他。
Compels him.
所以他一直要为神做事情。
So he kept working for the Lord.
那为什么癫狂呢？
Why did he mention if he was beside himself?
因为有一些人不了解他。
Or some people did not understand him.
像你这样的人才，为什么会这样糟蹋，传这个基督教？
Some people wonder, a man of your talent and skill, how did you fall into this circumstance?
你没有信耶稣之前什么都有，信了主耶稣之后什么都没有。
Of preaching, and before you believed in Christ, you possessed many things, and now that you believe in Christ, you have nothing.
你不是头脑有问题吗？
Is there not something wrong with your mind?
保罗说啊，如果被人看成为癫狂啊，这样子认真工作，这样牺牲那么大。
So Paul says, if I am seen as beside myself, the way I devote myself to serve God,
是为了神。
It is because of God.
弟兄姐妹，今天有没有你的朋友曾经说，你为什么花那么多时间在教会？
Brothers and sisters, do you have friends that question you why you spend so much time in church?
整天都在教会。
That you spend your entire day in church.
开口闭口就叫人家信耶稣。
And every time you open your mouth, you ask people to believe in Jesus.
你都没有生活了，整天都在教会里面。
You have no life, all you do is live at church.
赚了钱就奉献教会。
And all the money that you make, you just offer it to church.
到底教会有什么好？
What is so good about church?
有时候朋友会不会这样子对你看你怪怪的？
Do your friends sometimes see you in this way?
哇，信耶稣，这个也不行做，那个也不行做。
I believe in Christ. You can't do this. You can't do that.
我觉得你们很奇怪。
We think you're weird.
没有错，我们是奇怪。
And it's true. We are weird.
如果别人看我们癫狂，是为了神。
If people see us as beside ourselves, it is for God.
哎呀，基督的恩典呢，一直在我们里面作王。
For the love of Christ, the grace of Christ, reigns in our heart.
最近我接触的几个教会里面呢，好多人生病。
Lately, I come across many church members who are sick.
啊，那种生病都是生量比较重的病。
And they have a more serious illness.
都很可能是不治之病，就是癌症啊之类的。
And then most of them have incurable diseases such as cancer.
那在我接触的这些弟兄姐妹当中呢，有一个共通点。
So when I came, all the brothers and sisters I came across have a commonality.
他们都讲几句话都是一样的。
They spoke of the similar sayings.
第一，他们对得救没有把握。
The first, they do not have confidence or assurance in their salvation.
如果现在要死啊，心中还不是很确定能不能得救。
If they were to die at that moment, they had no confidence if they were be saved or not.
第二呢？
The second,
他们都讲说，我做主的工作的太少。
They commented that they did very little work for God.
如果主能够让我活下来，
but if God can allow me to live longer,
我一定大大的奉献。
I will try my hardest to offer myself.
我一定多多的做工。
I will do even more work for God.
这是我听到的一些生重病的弟兄姐妹通常会讲的话。
These are some of the words that I hear from brothers and sisters who have encountered terminal illnesses.
那我就想，为什么我们有时候一定要等到生很重病的时候才有这样的想法？
Sometimes I think to myself, why do we have to wait till we encounter a serious illness to have these kind of thoughts?
一定要等到生病的时候才觉得自己不够好，可能得救没把握吗？
Do we have to wait until we fall ill to realize that we do not have any confidence or assurance in our salvation?
一定要等到生命可能会结束的时候才想说，哎呀，如果主给我多一点时间，我可以多做。
Do we have to wait until the time where our life might end to reflect on how much more we could have done for God?
才来献身当传道。
To then offer our lives to become a minister.
才来捐多点钱，或者是为主做义工。
To then offer more money or to do more volunteer work.
一定要等到那个时候吗？
Do we have to wait until that moment?
保罗，基督的爱，每时每刻都在里面烧。
Paul was compelled by the love of Christ constantly.
因为基督的恩典在他生命当中作王。
For the grace of Christ reigned in his heart.
再来我们讲基督主耶稣基督真神怎么在我们生命中作王。
Next, let's talk about how Lord Jesus Christ reigns in us.
他要在我们，我们要追求他要在我们的家庭里面也是要作王。
We have to pursue so that he can reign in our families.
我们看回来罗马书的第五章。
Let's turn back to Romans 5.
第五章的十四节。
Romans 5 verse 14.
罗马书五章的十四节。
Romans 5 verse 14.
然而从亚当到摩西，死就做了王，连那些不与亚当犯一样罪过的，也在他的权下。
Nevertheless, death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over those who had not sinned according to the likeness of the transgression of Adam.
这里说罪也是透过亚当进到人类的历史当中作王。
Says here that death reigned from Adam into human history.
那其实它不是只有影响亚当一个人。
But it did not affect only Adam.
它是影响亚当的家庭。
It affected Adam's entire family.
就是先影响他的太太。
First affected his wife.
来再透过太太影响丈夫。
And then from the wife, then affected the husband.
再透过父母的犯罪的罪性，再影响下一代。
And then because of their transgressions, it affected their offspring.
所以魔鬼要毁灭人类，就是要毁灭家庭的信仰。
For the devil to destroy mankind, he would start through the families.
那家庭呢，就从婚姻还有父母跟儿女之间的关系开始来破坏。
He would start destroying the marriages and also relationships between parents and children.
如果你看仔细看创世纪的故事，
if we read closely the stories in Genesis,
就是家用一句话，就是很多家庭的悲剧加起来的总结。
I mean, it's basically a summary of all the tragedies in the family. All the tragedies that occurred after this original sin.
比如说犯罪之后，夫妻的感情就变化了，就不太和睦了。
For instance, after committing sin, the relationship between husband and wife soured.
以前讲话都很亲密的。
They used to speak each other, to each other very gently.
亚当一看到夏娃就哇，你是我骨中的骨，肉中的肉啊。
When Adam saw Eve, he says, "You are the flesh of my flesh and the bone of my bones."
现在犯了罪之后，第一句就说，那个同居的女人。
And after sinning,
同居的而已啊。
After sinning, he referred to her as just that woman that dwells with me.
哇，马上就不一样，不讲甜话了，在这讲那种咸的话了。
And all the lovely sayings changed in a heartbeat.
那第五章里面呢？ 第四章呢，就讲人类的兄弟的仇杀，就是家庭也是出问题。In
Genesis chapter 4, it records of brothers killing each other.
那不到几百年呢？
This is not even after 100 years.
创世纪第六章呢，要讲人类的家庭的制度啊，从属灵上来看呢，就彻底的失败了。Not
100 years later, in Genesis chapter 6, it describes how the families have gotten so wicked.
我们看六章。
Let us read chapter 6.
第六章的第一节。
Chapter 6, verse 1.
六章的第一节。
Chapter 6, verse 1.
当人在世上多起来要生儿女的时候，女儿的时候，第二节。
Verse 2.
神的儿子们看人的女子们美貌，就随意挑选娶来为妻。第三节。
Verse 3.
主说：人既属乎血气，我的灵就不永远住在他里面。然而他的日子还可以到120年。第四节。
Verse 4.
那时候有伟人在地上，后来。 神的儿子们与人的女子们交合生子，那就是上古英武有名的人。这几节圣经是讲人类家庭的堕落。This
passage records the downfall of the human families.
本来人的家庭里面有小部分的人呢，还有神在他们的中间。In
the beginning, in every family, there were at least some part of God inside that family.
这一批人有信仰呢，叫做神的儿子们。And
these people with faith, they're called the sons of God.
这是赛特的后代。
Which are the descendants of Seth.
但是他们呢，看到人的女子们，人的女子们就是该隐的后代，就是没有神的，没有神的思想的这个后代。
They saw the daughters of men, which are those without faith, which are the descendants of Cain.
所以有神的人跟没有神的人的这种家庭结合之后呢，大部分呢都变成没有神在他们中间的这种状态。
So families with God, after marrying families without God, it often results in this downfall of faith loss.
这跟数学是一样的，一个正跟一个负加起来都是一个负 ，positive negative 啊。就是 like in
math, if you multiply a positive number by a negative number,
正强负都是负的嘛。 当然这个就是当时的状态。This
is the situation at the time.
所以不久之后的整个挪亚的时代了，全部都是罪人。Not
long after, the people in Noah's time were all sinful.
所以魔鬼要控制世界，他只需要控制家庭就可以了。For
the Satan to control the world, he needs to just start from these families.
所以你看现在我们的社会为什么那么多的问题？So
we can observe the problems we have in society today.
全部的问题都是家庭的问题。
Most of the problems stem from the families.
社会最大的问题不是环保的问题，也不是经济的问题，也不是政治的问题。The
greatest problem facing mankind is not our environment or economics.
那个是表象，最外层。
Those are the superficial, the aggregate problems.
那个根源就是家庭的问题。But
the root begins in the family.
为什么有家庭的问题？Why
are there family problems?
就是人把神从家庭里面拉走了。
Because man has taken God out of the family.
大部分的人家庭里面已经变成没有信仰了。Most
families no longer have any faith.
下一步就是人把神从社会里面把神拿走。The
next step is that people take God away from their society.
把从学校里面把神拿走。And
take God out of schools.
那今天就变成我们这个社会的样子。And
today it resulted in the society we see today.
那所以如果我们今天要改变。Today,
if we want to have a revolution.
尤其是我们信主的人。
Especially for believers.
我们要让主耶稣基督在我们的家庭里面，你这个家为单位里面作王。We
have to allow Lord Jesus to reign in a throne in our families.
怎么样让主耶稣在我们家里作王？How
do we allow him to reign on the throne in our families?
我们看《生命记》的第六章。Let's
read Deuteronomy 6.
生命记第六章。Deuteronomy
6.
第四节到第九节。Deuteronomy
6 verses 4 to 9.
这就是以色列人他们每一个安息日在会堂里面都会念的一段。
These are the phrases that the Israelites recited every Sabbath.
他们说, 以色列啊, 你要听, 主我们的神是独一的主。
So hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one.
这是一种观念。
This is a very important concept.
这是一种价值观。
This is a value.
神是最重要的。
God is the most important.
其他都是次要的。
Everything else is second in second place.
犹太人从古到今都是 常常念诵这句话，变成他们的观念。
The Jews from early on till now, they often recite these words.
然后呢，你要第五节，你要尽心、尽性、尽力爱主你的神。
And then they say, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength."
啊，你怎么教导你的儿女？
How do we teach our children?
首先，你要给他一个理论，一个价值观。
First, you give them this value system.
神是最重要的。
God is the most important.
一切免谈。
And everything else is secondary.
没得让步。 敬拜神是最重要的。
Cannot compromise with that. Worshipping God is most important.
第二呢，你要做给他看。
The second is that you have to demonstrate it to them.
什么叫做爱神？
What does it mean to love God?
爸爸妈妈爱神，爱给你看，你看我怎么爱神的。
Dad and mom love God, and here's the way that we show our love to God.
用这种行动来教他。
We use our actions to teach them.
然后呢，第七节。
And then verse 7.
一直来有机会，机会教育，就跟他讲神，就跟他讲信仰，殷勤教导。
And so they have these teaching moments. And they teach by example.
让他们去背，头脑去背。
And they have them memorize these words.
小孩子对道理的领悟力啊，领悟力比较低。
Children's understanding aptitude is a little bit lower.
小孩子的背记忆力很好。
But they have a very uncanny skill to memorize.
只要你让他背。
As long as you have them memorized,
只要他背得进去,
and they can retain it
in
their memory, then they will never forget it throughout their entire lives.
背多了，就变成他的思想的一部分。
The more that they remember, the more that it becomes ingrained as part of their value system.
这个讲得不好听，叫做洗脑。
In a very negative way to say this is to brainwash.
那对我们来说，洗也不错啊，把它洗干净啊。
But to us, it's a sort of a cleansing.
对不对？它本来是不干净的，我们用圣经的话给它洗脑啊。
So originally they were bad, but then we use the words of God to clean them.
外面的观念，外面的文化是这样，但是神的话是这样。
Outside culture and society is one way, but God is this way.
让它背在里面，在里面洗。
And have them recite and recite and recite.
看到爸爸妈妈这样做。
And they can observe and witness their parents performing the actions.
这样做之后，我这个家庭很美满，很幸福。
And after they see the results of a very harmonious and joyous family.
你这样做，你这样 copy 我，你这样跟我一样的话，你也会一样的幸福。
And if the children learn that if they just imitate their parents, they will also receive this kind of a blessing.
这个就是让神在家庭里面做王。
This is what it means to have God reign in our household.
我礼拜二的时候啊，从多伦多坐飞机来。 Los Angeles 来这个美国加州这边。这个
flight last Tuesday from Toronto to Los Angeles.
我在机场的时候，在排队 check in 过海关的时候，一直留意为什么有那么多犹太人在坐飞机啊
？I noticed that as I was going through immigration, I observed many Jews in the airport.
我很好奇。And
I was very curious.
第一，你可能问我为什么你一看他就知道是犹太人。The
first, you may ask me, how do you know they were Jews?
其实犹太人很好认。
Actually, they're very easy to spot.
当然，从他的衣服当中你可以认得出来，有一些特别虔诚的。
From the more devout ones, you can tell from their attire.
有一些老的，哇，那个这个胡子白白的。
Some of the older ones, they grow their beards out.
戴一个黑帽子，那个穿那个黑西装。And
they put the little hat behind them.
有一些小男生呢，戴一个犹太帽，那个盖着头顶。And
they wear the Jewish hats, and then they dress up very sharp.
那我看他的行李啊，就打开，哇，带着一大本的这个 Torah。
And then I see them opening up their suitcases, and they brought out a big Torah book.
从我排队到我登上了飞机，还是看到很多犹太人。
From the time that I was waiting in line for the time I boarded the plane, I saw a lot of Jews.
那我在想，到底是什么日子？
I was thinking to myself, what special occasion is it?
后来就上网查了一下。
And then I went online and did some research.
原来啊，从昨天晚上开始就是逾越节的开始。
So actually, the previous night was the beginning of the Passover.
今天就是逾越节，犹太人的逾越节。今天。
And so today is actually the Passover for the Jews.
到今天，等一下太阳下山才结束。
Until the time the sun sets today.
是纪念他们的先祖。
Is to remember their ancestors.
在神的带领之下，透过摩西带领他们出埃及。
Under the guidance of God, they were led by Moses out of Egypt.
这个是一个我们都很熟悉的故事。
It's a very familiar story to each of us.
犹太人他们不认识主耶稣，也还没有相信主耶稣。The
Jews do not believe in Lord Jesus.
他们还是活在旧约里面。They
still live in the Old Testament.
还没有得救。They
are not saved yet.
有时候我看他们，那是蛮佩服他们的那种信仰。
But sometimes I admire their faith. They're not afraid of people looking down on them.
也不会怕别人呢, 啊, 觉得他们很奇怪,
and they're not afraid of people thinking that they're weird.
他们穿着不一样,
they're dressed differently.
饮食不一样,
they eat differently.
他们学希伯来文, 学圣经的话语,
they learn Hebrew, the words of the scriptures.
他跟别的文化有点格格不入,
and they're unable to assimilate to other cultures.
但是那些孩子的还是乖乖的这样子做,
but the children are very obedient and continue to follow this.
他们的信仰呢，这一代一代这样传下去。
And their faith is passed down from generation to generation.
为什么？
Why?
从家里开始。
It starts from the family.
因为父母要非常认真的用信仰在家庭里面教育他们。
The parents are very diligent in teaching them.
啊，所以虽然小小的孩子啊，早早就背好律法。
Even though the children are very young, but at a young age, they've already memorized
从小,
the commandments.
这有这个身份，这个 identity。
And they're young, they already had this identity.
我是神的选民, 你们不是。
I am the chosen of God, you are not.
他不是觉得不好意思,
they do not feel ashamed.
他觉得很骄傲啊,
they actually feel proud.
我穿这样因为我是神的选民啊,
I dress this way because I'm a chosen child of God.
我不去你们的 Christmas party, 去圣诞节舞会, 因为我是神的选民啊,
I do not attend your Christmas party because I'm a chosen child of God.
我不去万圣节的舞会, 因为我是神的选民啊,
I don't go to Halloween parties because I am a child of God.
我礼拜六不做生意, 门都不开, 因为是神的选民啊,
I don't do business on Saturdays because I am a child of God. I'm a chosen child of God.
我不会安排我孩子礼拜六去补习、去踢足球、去学什么，因为礼拜六是安息日，我是神的选民啊。
I will not arrange for my child to have extracurricular activities on the Saturday because this is a special day for God.
哇，他们有勇气这样做。
They have the courage and boldness to do this.
把旧约的律法很认真的去守。
They keep the Old Testament laws very faithfully.
你仔细看, 神也很祝福, 在物质上也很祝福犹太人。
If you observe closely, God actually blesses them quite abundantly,
没有,
materially.
没有因为他少工作一天呢, 就变穷。
And not because they did not work open for business one day that they became poor.
反而犹太人得到神的祝福, 全世界哪里做生意, 做得很好。
But rather, the Jews are blessed by God in this way that no matter where they open their businesses, they generally do well.
为什么?
Why?
守安息日。
Because they observe the Sabbath.
在家里把这个信仰传到下一代。
And in their household, they pass on the faith to the next generation.
那我们想想我们现在的信仰, 我们家庭的状况。
Now if we think about our faith in our household today,
我们有时候以为说, 啊, 我把孩子生出来了, 把他带到教会的儿童班, 我都尽了我的责任了。
Sometimes we feel that I gave birth to my child, I raised them, and I brought them to church, to RE classes, and that's enough for me to do.
让教会的老师去教他吧。
We'll let the RE teachers take care of them.
你会发觉在现在的这个社会，现在这种文化，这个方法已经不够了。
We find that in today's society, today's culture, this method is no longer effective.
外面的文化的力量影响太大。The
power of the cultural influence is too great.
除非我们现在开始让神在我们家庭里面作王。
Unless today we make a determination to allow God to reign in our family.
除了全家一起来教会之外,
besides coming to church as an entire household,
在家里用神的话, 去引导我们的儿女。
At home, we use the words of God to guide our children.
陪他一起祷告。
Accompany them, join them in prayer.
克服生命当中的一些困难。
Overcome many of life's challenges.
陪伴他们信仰的成长。
To be with them during this growth in their faith.
或者是夫妻之间遇到一些问题。
Or if husband and wife encounter problems.
没有办法解决。
And they're unable to solve it themselves.
那怎么解决呢？
Then how shall they solve it?
怎么办呢?
What shall they do?
在新约里面有一对很聪明的夫妻。
In the New Testament, there was a famous couple.
他们也遇到困难。
They also encountered a challenge.
这是新约的玛利亚跟约瑟。
This is Mary and Joseph in the New Testament.
他们的婚姻还没有结婚之前就出了一个危机了。
They encountered a crisis even before they were married.
这个什么危机呢?
What was the crisis?
玛利亚还没有嫁过去, 肚子都一天一天大了。
Before Mary was betrothed to her husband, her belly was growing bigger and bigger.
已经从圣灵怀了孕了。
She was already pregnant by the Holy Spirit.
约瑟就想暗暗地把她休了。
Joseph wanted to put her away quietly.
如果是这样休了，那这段婚姻、这段订婚就没有了。
And if he did so, then that marriage would have not ever happened.
但是神 帮助他们，神介入了。
But God intervened for them.
我们看马太福音第一章。
Let's read Matthew chapter 1.
马太福音第一章。
Matthew chapter 1.
第20节。
Matthew 1 verse 20.
马太福音第一章20节。
Matthew 1 verse 20.
马太一章的20节。
Matthew 1 verse 20.
正思念这事的时候, 有主的使者向他梦中显现, 说大卫的子孙约瑟, 不要怕，只管娶过你的妻子玛利亚来，因她所怀的孕是从圣灵来的。
But while he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary for your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit.
在当约瑟想要有这个意念要把她休了，把这个婚姻放弃的时候。
When Joseph had the secret notion to put her away secretly,
天使跟他显现
the angel revealed himself to him.
不用怕，把她娶过来。
Do not be afraid to take Mary your wife.
这个怀孕是圣灵来的。
For this child is conceived by the Holy Spirit.
神直接给他答案，给他疑惑的答案。
God gave him a direct answer.
这段婚姻是可以走下去的。
That you can go down this marriage.
你不用怕。
Don't be afraid.
我是跟你们同在的。
I am with you.
因为这个是要生出来是救主啊。
For that who was to be born would be the Savior.
那另外一方面，玛利亚呢？当她肚子越来越大的时候，她也很困惑。
When Mary's belly was getting bigger and bigger, she was also a little distressed.
但是天使也是给她讲。
But the angel also assured her.
你是有福气的。
You are blessed.
所以鼓励她。
So they encouraged her.
她就说：“我的心尊主为大。”
And she says, I will magnify the Lord.
她不强调自己了。
She will no longer emphasize herself on herself.
这个不是她想象，也不是她期待的。
This is not something that she imagined for herself.
但既然主要我接受这个方式。
Since the Lord wants me to accept this way,
好了，那我就接受。
Then I will accept it.
感谢主，那就把主耶稣生下来。
And thank the Lord, then she gave birth to Lord Jesus Christ.
主耶稣就透过这个家庭降到世界上面。
And Lord Jesus came into this earth through this family.
这个家庭啊，是以神为王，神为主。
This family magnified the Lord first in their lives.
如果你有信心。
If we have faith,
没有什么家庭问题是靠主解决不了的。
There is no family problems that can't be solved by the Lord.
只要你有信心。
If we have faith,
没有什么儿女的问题是主耶稣没有办法帮你解决的。
There is no filial problems that cannot be solved by the Lord.
除非你信不下去。
It's only if we can no, if we stop believing.
你没有办法靠主。
Then we can no longer rely on the Lord.
如果你要把王位这自己。从这个王位拿走，请主耶稣来做。
If we remove ourselves from the throne and invite the Lord Jesus to reign,
主一定跟你同在。
The Lord will surely be with us.
唱诗。
Let us sing him.
448首。
Let us rise and sing him 448.